If you watch this video until the end, you'll probably be the first wealthy person in your family because I'm going to teach very important things. Let me ask you, do you want to succeed in life? You can learn to succeed just like you learn mathematics, chemistry, or biology. Just as you learn these subjects, you can learn to succeed as well. This is entirely different from being successful. For instance, a soccer player might have a lot of success on the field, but their personal life could be a mess. That person might succeed in soccer, but isn't successful in life. To be successful, you need to work on various areas: personal, professional, financial, family, social, and friendships. That's the big difference between success and being successful. What are you aiming for? Do you want success in something specific, or do you want to be successful overall? Leave your comment. I'll tell you right away. If you want to be successful, watch the video until the end because you'll find valuable tips. You might be thinking that to be successful, you'd have to be born with a silver spoon. But no, successful people often had difficult childhoods. In France, 85% of successful people came from humble families, worked as employees, and faced tough times. Your past is gone and cannot be changed, but your future isn't written yet. You can start writing it today. If you grasp this, it'll make a huge difference in your life by understanding this perspective of tomorrow. We are the only animals on planet Earth capable of transcending. That means starting anew, no matter where you were born, your upbringing, or what you've done until today. Tomorrow can begin as if it were the first page of a new book. That's transcending, but to do that, we need to make some modifications first. We all know about a series of beliefs. Our operational mode is based on these beliefs, which often are unfavorable and don't yield the desired results. A belief becomes obsolete when it doesn't provide what we want, which is to evolve. Let's eliminate the obsolete beliefs that don't bring desirable results. We don't need to reinvent the wheel. The secret is to make it spin faster because someone has done it before. Studied millionaires, successful people, not only financially, but in family, health, and identified common habits of these successful individuals. To move towards success, it's important to know where you're starting from. First, your level of self-esteem. I'll conduct a questionnaire about five areas of your life: health, family, finances, professional life, and friendships. For each of them, rate yourself from 1 to 10, then add up these scores to understand your position. Let's start with health. Assess your health. If you rarely get sick, rate it a 10. If you're constantly ill, rate it a 1. Consider vices as well, like smoking, drinking, or using illicit drugs, as they affect this evaluation. Next, evaluate your family, considering the family unit as a whole, from parents to siblings. If it's a perfect family with no necessary changes, rate it a 10. Regarding finances, evaluate your emergency fund. If you lost your job today, how long could you maintain your current lifestyle? That's your emergency fund. If you manage your money well, giving it the opportunity to work for you, rate it high. Otherwise, the score will be low. In your professional life, question whether you'd continue the same activity if you won a lot of money in the lottery. Your answer will indicate your satisfaction in this area. Lastly, assess your friendships. Add up all these scores to understand your self-esteem and where you stand in terms of success. Comparing a poor, unsuccessful individual with a successful millionaire, you'll notice their routines don't differ much in terms of schedules. The difference lies in strategically executed small details, which makes all the difference. Upon discovering that you operate with only 60% of self-esteem, the question arises: how to improve? The more specific it is, the easier it'll be to create a change. Everything in the physical universe was created twice, first in the mind and then in reality. Be mindful of the internal dialogue you maintain. When negative dialogue arises, cancel it. Body posture is also relevant. Observe how people behave around you, which reflects a lot about them. The language you use is crucial. Focus on what you want to achieve, not what you want to avoid. The mother who says, "Do not disturb," is unconsciously focusing on disturbance. Focus on what you truly want, on your goal. Moreover, the world's largest football stadium will remain for posterity. If you can change your internal dialogue and focus on what you desire, your actions will follow that direction. Paradigm shift expands possibilities. What seems impossible can become possible when we change our perspective. Problems are actually disguised opportunities. Losing a job can be the starting point to become an entrepreneur. What happens doesn't determine the future, but what we do with what happens. Self-esteem, communication, attitude, ambition, goals, work, and mission are the elements to be developed. Focus on strengths to neutralize weaknesses. Preparation is key for when the opportunity arises. Everything in the physical universe was created twice, first in the mind and then in reality. Internal dialogue is crucial. Cancel negative dialogues. The language used is essential. Focus on what you want to achieve, not what you want to avoid. A paradigm shift expands possibilities. Problems are, in fact, disguised opportunities. What happens doesn't determine the future, but what we do with what happens. Look how interesting. Both of them physically do the same thing. They put one brick on top of another, but one sees it only as work, and the other has a broader perspective. So, this other person won't be a bricklayer for long. Soon, they will be the owner of a construction company. Secondly, you are judged by your appearance. If you want to play for Real Madrid, don't show up there wearing Barcelona's uniform. If you want to join the army, don't show up there in shorts. It's not just what you say, but how you say it. Two individuals can say the same thing, and the repercussion will be completely different. There's a phrase that goes like this: the singer is more important than the song. You're a fan of a great singer, right? I imagine they have a song that touches your heart. The same song sung by a singer you don't like wouldn't have the same impact on you. So, know what you're going to say, how you're going to say it, and at the right time, okay? Let me see another important knowledge. People give up before things happen, which is why patience and persistence are essential. I wanted to talk to you now about goals. You need to learn to turn a dream into a goal, and then we'll learn to turn a goal into reality, right? How do I turn a dream into a goal? I turn a dream into a goal by setting a date. Everything you want someday won't happen. Then you'll have a dusty book on the shelf in your house. You, as a person, have lived until today. What happened that was most important? Three events: your marriage, the birth of your child, or a promotion at your job, passing the entrance exam, graduating from college. There are many important things in your life, but you'll notice that at least two or three were not planned. You didn't wake up one day and say, "Today I'm going to meet someone because I'm going to fall in love and I'm going to marry them." It didn't happen that way. You just went somewhere, fell in love, planned, and took a risk. What risk are you taking? If you're a mother, one day your children will grow up, leave. We raise children for the world. They don't stay with us. They go take care of their lives. So, what are you going to say? "Oh, but now I feel empty." It's the empty nest syndrome. It's the mother who dedicated her entire life to her children. The children grew up, went to take care of their lives, and the mother feels alone. So for this reason, you have to have diversity. You have to have a financial goal. You have to have a personal goal. Many with both eyes painted, and some with only one eye painted, because the goal has to be remembered. For example, are you going to study medicine just because it's your parents' dream? No, 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 it's all wrong. Tell your father to take the entrance exam. You have to pursue a goal that is yours, that you really desire, understand? If an Asian says he's going to buy a new house, and when he buys it, he goes there and paints the other eye of the doll. If you enter an Asian's house, you will hover, because the earth will be round. Now you can make a round-the-world trip on a round earth. The paradigm shift multiplies possibilities. What is impossible for you today is impossible in the paradigm you are operating. The moment you change the paradigm, it becomes possible. Making a round-the-world trip on a flat earth is impossible. The moment the earth became round, it became possible. Interesting. What is impossible today in your life is impossible based on... Pay attention. Our problems are our best friends. You don't know it, but a problem can revolutionize your life. You lost your job. Now you can become an entrepreneur. Did you know that? It's not what happens in your life that determines how it will be from now on, but what you do with what happens. So, I have self-esteem, I have communication, I have attitude, I have ambition, I have goals, I have work, and I have a mission. So the job is as follows. We have to study ourselves. The day you leave the company, you will take this improvement with you. Napoleon Hill, studying millionaires, concluded that 85% of millionaires before becoming millionaires worked for someone. But they worked with the following attitude. They worked as if the company were theirs. They made it yield more with their effort. They spent as if it were theirs. They managed the company as if it were theirs. The day they opened their own, they knew. What is being a cosmic address? And when you get to the other side, they will ask you three questions. The first question is, what did you learn there? This is a school, we are learning. The second question is, how is your passage on planet Earth? Did you make a better place for those who will come after you? And lastly, and most importantly of all, they will ask you, did you cost more than you contributed? Or did you contribute more than you cost? Or better, I recommend to you, when you put yourself as a professional instead of an amateur, it's patience and persistence. I don't need to worry about my weaknesses. I need to focus on my strengths. These strengths will make my weaknesses disappear. That's the big catch. So if you're not prepared, it's no use. If I offer you $20,000 a month to teach German in Germany and you don't speak German, it's no use. So when you're prepared and the opportunity comes, because it will come, and most of the time it comes in the form of a problem. So when it comes and you're prepared, people call it luck. Luck is nothing more than the opportunity arriving and you being prepared to seize it. In other words, your luck is built by you. That person who is adrift waiting for things to happen, nothing will happen. That's the big problem. Be prepared when the big opportunity comes. If you watch this video until here, comment like this. This is the secret of life. Just comment that. This is the secret of life. When I see this comment, I will know that you watched this whole video, and that shows that you are a persistent and patient person. You are closer to success than those who left halfway through the video. Now I imagine you want to increase your knowledge even more, right? So on your screen, there is a video where I will teach you how to get out of poverty and achieve wealth in 6 months. So click on it and go watch it now.